Welcome to Brockton Community Schools Act One Scene One in its 40th annual summer production. Certainly a time to celebrate and enjoy our anniversary tribute to a favorite storyteller of us all, Dr. Seuss. And as he would say, there's always something fun to do when we tick-tock time away with you. And now, Brockton Community Schools proudly presents Act One Scene One in Crunch Time with a capital G, or of SEUSS way beyond Z and the Grunch. Sala salut!
That's Dr. Seuss. Thank you. Tonight! Grunch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from stores. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
And what happened then? Well, the people on Google say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day.
Hey, everyone, are you ready for this year's show? don't want to be singing and dancing. They're missing the entire point of what it means to be alive. Life is painful. It's ugly. It's disappointing. The exact opposite of a musical.
They do have beautiful costumes every year.
Oh sure. Beautiful costumes, incredible sets, sparkly lights. Why do people recognize true talent? Like the fact that I was the one who won the Hoover Regional Chess Tournament last year? Did I get a write-up in the paper? Did I get flowers and balloons? Did I get hundreds of people coming to my match and a standing ovation? No.
I was there.
Of course you were there. You're my cousin. Aunt Kathy says you have to stick with me.
I just don't get what bothers you so much about school musicals.
Where do I start? The auditions, the fundraising, the endless morning announcements. Oh, Mills, I can see it already. First the crowd rushing up as they find the audience, and they paint the hall. Then they rush up and find out they were in, and it got past the end call. Now I love my whole cast and director, for I feel like we're feeling a team.
I'm so glad I got cast on Kevin the Clock.
It's enough to make me want to scream. They take over the gym and the halls in the yard as if nobody else needs the space. They think everyone's glad, but their logic is barred. If it's just me, make this place. Oh, I dreamt about this the whole summer, and at last I am finally a star.
Every day we rehearse them, rehearse each breakfast.
Don't you find their exuberance bizarre?
Writes music.
bravissimo!
Okay, guys, I think it's safe. You can take off your disguises. Remind me again why we're having this meet down here in the 42nd Street subway station.
As the nation's top critics, we can't let it be known that our jobs are on the line.
Tell me about it. I've been moonlighting as a saxophone player just to make ends meet.
We must find a way to bring energy into our reviews. Or soon, we may actually have to pay for our theater tickets.
No!
Indeed, I am present, and I am begging you to entertain me.
Variety? Now this is the Grit that we need to bring back into the theater. New York Post?
These sets must have gone way over budget. I'm calling an accountant.
And backstage?
Present.
Okay, who would like to begin?
I am. The problem is now our review, but the play we're reviewing.
It's true. I'm still trying to forget what I saw last night. Tax Codes, the musical. Just what has theater come to? How can a critic be a good critic when everything puts us to sleep? It's difficult writing reviews when every night we're counting sheep.
How can a critic be a good critic when nothing we see is from lunch? If nothing is worthy of praise, our readers have nothing to do.
your hat.
Maybe this play could save our job.
Do you think
it could?
Yes.
It's gotta be good to keep our jobs.
It's gotta be good to keep our jobs.
But it's written by the students.
Heard they got a play with print tea
flowers.
Flowers.
And they've been rehearsing for umpteen hours.
Hours?
Got a new kid by the name of Grunch?
Yes,
ma'am. But I heard he doesn't like the stage.
No, ma'am.
But it doesn't really matter because I heard it's good.
How good?
Good.
It's gotta be good to keep our jobs.
It's gotta be good to keep our jobs.
But it's written by the students.
Anyone know of something like?
I heard they got lights from across the pond.
Big money.
Million lights and moon and glow.
Snow?
Real snow.
But it doesn't really matter because I heard it's good.
How good?
Good.
It's gotta be good to keep our jobs.
Yes.
It's gotta be good to keep our jobs.
Excuse me, can I bother you for a comment? What's your character in the musical?
Oh no, I'm not an actor.
Then you must be a writer.
How does it feel to have read the most talks about musicals since the novel Normal?
Well, I'm not a writer either.
Well, if you're not a writer, not enough to write a second to you.
I take care of everything backstage.
That's it? You don't get jealous of Leslie and Javier getting all the attention?
No, not at all.
Green, making sure nothing falls on you.
even though it was a dark, empty, silent theater when they arrived overnight.
Jack made
precisely. really sorry, guys. I thought I could ruin the play by taking away the sets, props, and costumes. But I guess theater's much more than that. I've never felt so thrilled with being on stage before. It was like I was part of something huge.
Didn't your heart grow, perchance, three sizes larger in thy chest?
Without the glamour.
Sometimes we perform being perfectly ready, and sometimes it's a wing and a prayer, and sometimes we just come out and do it. And tonight they came out and they did it, and 2 weeks! And I hope that all of you are as proud of your children as we are of them. Every year at this time, or for the past 3 summers or 2 summers, it's been my pleasure to present the Midsummer Magic Scholarship Award in memory of Jean Herbert. And this year, the award is presented to Jade Etienne. Imagination to believe, roots to sprout, and wings to soar. And that's what we believe that the Act One, Scene One program is about. And Jean Herbert, who was one of the first people, or one of the first ones here at the new high school as secretary of the community school when Act One, Scene One first evolved. And this would be very much what she was like and what she would want for young people today. And we thank all of you for coming, and we thank you for your support, and we give this award to Jade now, and it is a scholarship to the program next year because we want to keep her coming. Very good. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Maxine Richardson. I'm Director of Community Schools, and I want to thank you all for coming and to support your children, the cast, and the crew. But most of all, tonight is a very special night because this is 40 years of Act One, Scene One, and it could not have been done without our love, Carol Thomas. And Carol has brought us through many, many magical moments on this stage, from dance steps to singing, to set design, to jazz hands, but all the magic of this stage always comes alive when we have Carol at the helm and with her staff, and we just couldn't do it without her and everybody else here. And congratulations to all the students as well. Thank you, and Carol.
Hi, first up, my name is John Maloney. I've been with Carol for 4 decades. And I was counting. Carol brought Broadway to Brockton in the late 1960s and early 70s. And someone, I think it was Harry Allen at the time, had the brilliant idea of starting a children's theater program for children 10 to 16. And Carol has brought Broadway to your children, your neighbors, your nephews, your nieces, your grandchildren. And not many towns, especially inner cities, kids get the opportunity to learn Broadway songs, to learn about Broadway. And so this is a very special program. And lots of towns around here ripped us off. But this is the original, and she's the original. I just want to say one last thing. Not only are your kids talented, but they have been a joy to work with. They are polite and courteous, no discipline, and that is a reflection on you. And we want to thank you for sending these kids to us. It was a real, real privilege. And the kids love you, Carol. Your staff loves you, and Brockton loves you. Thank you very much.